better than the best. Here they are. Get in the ring. Get in the ring. Catch this beat down. They start off Sasha Banks, though. That's an interesting decision, but I like it. Let's go. Ooh. Let the bodies hit the floor. Let the bodies hit the floor. Walk-in default entrance. Hey. I only have so much time in a day. I made him a team at least, right? I mean, that's good. Don't get me wrong. I do believe that Charlotte is OP in her own ways, but it's night and day, man. She's going to have to put together something awesome to beat Nia Jax toe-to-toe. But then again, she's so fast, and she knows so much about wrestling. Who knows? We're going to find out right here, though. Tags in Nia Jax. The crowd goes wild, of course. The crowd is going to go wild the first time Nia Jax hits that ring, because 90% of them are going to have watched NXT before and know that this is the second coming of the most dominant female within the WWE. You ask me who the first most dominant woman in the WWE is? The one with the streak, Nikki Bella. Don't question me. Look at the record books. They deserve defaults. Don't question me. Look at the record books. Come here. Get kicked. The stoppage is inevitable. Yo, tagging your partner. You know right now she would tag her partner. Look at this. This mirrors reality so well. She would tag it her partner so quick. She'd be like, okay, so your turn. Your turn to take on Nia. Straight up. Come here. Irish whips off the ropes. Ooh, puts her down. Nia doesn't go down that easily, though. Takes a few. Once again, thank you to everybody who has donated, everybody who has clicked follow during the stream. I see you guys. You guys and girls. Because, yes, girls actually watch this stream as well, and I got to say thank you very much. Spending the time in here with us. Could be anywhere in the world, but you're here. I should just play the beginning of this song. Just gonna play the beginning of the song because this is what I'm trying to recreate for you with that speech. Goodness gracious. Oh, that song is so good. I love that song from the bottom of my heart. I'm playing the rest of that when this match ends. Oh, the strength. Yo, Charlotte. No way. Charlotte. That's a WrestleMania moment. You don't do that at Battleground. You don't do that at Battleground. You do that at WrestleMania. She's jumping the gun, man. I told her. I was like, Charlotte, you should do that. You should show off your strength like that. But not yet. Do it at WrestleMania. And obviously, you have a plan until you get punched in the mouth. And that punch to the mouth literally made her forget what month it is. Charlotte, please remember. It is July. It's not time for WrestleMania yet. Nice suplex. Get wrecked. I think it's going to be Nikki, except Nia. Who is it going to be? What do you think? Maybe Bailey. Maybe Bailey. Maybe even Marie. I don't know. I really don't know. But Nia Jax would be the most hype pick, I believe. People would be very hyped to see Bailey come out with Sasha Banks. But I think the reaction from the crowd, if Nia Jax is her partner, would be cheering. Excuse me. It would be cheering, but it would also be like fear for the other team. And that's what I would love to see at Battleground. It's called Battleground, man. I think they should put the most fear, the opponent that puts the most fear in the hearts of all the women in the WWE, they should put her out there. It would be perfect for the theme of this. Put Nia Jax with her. Such a good idea. It's going to be Bailey. I think it's like 90% sure. We'll see, man. We're not far away from it. Gritty for president. Yes, if you guys don't know about my campaign, I am running for president. I'm not kidding. I'm running for president. All you guys have to do is when the vote comes up, uno, dos. It's only dos. When the vote comes up this year, you go to vote and you write Gritty Urban in. Okay, you just write me in. You can write in whoever you want. This is what people are forgetting about voting. Voting is not cut and dry. You don't have to vote for Trump. You don't have to vote for you know, Hillary Clinton. You don't have to vote for these people. You can vote for me. So when you go to the box, fill it in with Gritty Urban. And if you want to see my campaign ad, it's on Twitter right now and it's on my YouTube channel. It's the top video on my YouTube channel, as a matter of fact. Go there, check it out, and you'll see. My platform is undeniable. It creates jobs. It creates great food for people. It's going to get even better because I'm going to be at the forefront of making it better. And it's just altogether going to make America the place, man. It's going to make it the spot. Check it out. Vote for me. I can see Bailey. Yep, you can vote on SpongeBob. You can vote on whoever you want. There's nothing stopping people from voting for whoever they would like. You can vote for Arnold Schwarzenegger. You can vote for Troy Baker. That way he can just be the voiceover of America like he is already. Vote for whoever you want. If you don't know who Troy Baker is, just look it up. You're going to see the voice acting credentials that are a mile long. It's like Santa's list of who was nice and who was naughty. Like, you're just going to see, it's going to roll out and continue to roll. You're going to be like, dang. They don't know how to hire anybody else for a video game today. Vote for Troy Baker. No, please don't. Please don't. The guy's going to wear scarves no matter what month it is. Don't do it. Vote for me. Sonic in every state. See? Sunshine Princess knows. She knows about the D-E-liciousness. And so does Nia Jax. She's not like most girls. She can definitely tell us that she eats some Sonic. She loves it just like we do. She turns that Sonic into the energy she needs to destroy other women in the WWE. That's a rhyme. What's the last president who rhymed? Who had a freestyle in the middle of his inauguration? Never happened. Never. Never. I'm going to be that dude. And yes, I will call myself that dude. Vote for me, guys. I'm telling you. I'm going to change America into something that is representative of the people, not just the people who normally vote. What's my thoughts on the draft? Did I like or dislike it? I liked it. He does so much voice acting. He even got into the anime industry, and it's kind of hard to get up there. Hey, that guy is ridiculous. I'm torn between voting for Gritty or Clive Barker. Oh, Clive Barker. He'll make this whole place a horror movie. You want to be scared to go outside, like, for real, for real? I don't know, man. Maybe you do. Not that I have anything against Clive Barker. I actually have novels by him. You want to see? I'll show you one right now. Look at the strength of Dana Brooke! Oh, my God! Yo, Dana Brooke? Hems are up! Uno! No, it's not enough. Hems are up? The strength of Dana Brooke. She's a former fitness competitor. I think she could do it. Have you seen her biceps, man? They rival most people. Most people. Look, here she goes. She's kissing the bicep, putting it on her. Oh, drops the elbow so pristine. Dana Brooke. Is this the match where she breaks out and gets her classic historical battle? Please. Please, Dana Brooke. Get your classic historical battle. I would love to be talking about this in 10 years from now. Remember the match at Battleground 2016? Dana Brooke versus Nia Jax. That's what we'll call the match because it's going to be that. Dana Brooke, please, get your classic historical battle. No, get snatched! The bank statement! It's the bank statement. And it reads your bank account is negative! You can't make it over there. But she breaks the hold. I don't know why. Gets the reversal, though. Dana Brooke, really? Okay. Do I think that they made Raw so much better than SmackDown? Not really. I think that they made Raw the predictable show, and I think they made SmackDown the unpredictable show. I think that there are great reasons to tune into SmackDown each week, and it's much more interesting than it would have been before. Because you never know who's going to show up on SmackDown. And also, I hope they stop that other stuff. You know what stuff I'm talking about? I'm talking about the stuff where every SmackDown they spend 20% of SmackDown just recapping what happened on Raw, and they replay matches, and it's like, come on, guys, we're watching SmackDown. I'm like, come on, I'm like, stop that. You're literally making your show seem like it matters less because you're like, hey, did you guys see what happened on Raw? Dude, we saw what happened on Raw. We're watching SmackDown. Are you kidding me? If I'm watching SmackDown, I saw what happened on Raw. It's not the other way around, though. It's not the other way around. I don't know what happened on SmackDown. Maybe Raw should start having this is what happened on SmackDown segments. But they won't. And they shouldn't. It's ridiculous, man. It's like SmackDown spent the last couple of years saying, hey, did you guys see Raw, by the way? Stop that. Don't do that. I don't care. I don't care what happened on Raw. I watched it. I wouldn't be watching SmackDown if I didn't see Raw. Trust me. You guys are like second place forever. So stop. Don't tell me what happened on Raw. I already know. Why would I be watching SmackDown if I didn't see Raw? Like, it's like saying, hey, man, do you see what the Bulls did last season? Where the Bulls won, like, all the championships ever? And you're like, hey, did you see what Golden State did? No, I don't see what Golden State did. I didn't see what Golden State did. I saw what the Bulls did. Why would Golden State be talking about the Bulls? Talk about yourself. Make yourself seem like it's awesome. He's a great writer. Rob Zombie for president. That dude. Yes, hashtag that dude. I'm just trying to keep it real with you guys, and I'm saying that the normal WWE fan, if you didn't see Raw, you're not a person who watches SmackDown. You're not. And if you're watching SmackDown, you already saw Raw because that's the must-see TV. So why are you spending 20% to 30% of your show telling me about Raw? Like, I already know, or else I wouldn't be a person watching SmackDown. You're second place. Why am I watching your show to begin with if I'm not a wrestling fan? I already saw it. Two counts. This is a great match. Knock off the BS. Yes, stop talking about each other's shows. The only time you should be talking about somebody else's show is if they cut a promo against somebody on the other show, because four times a year, these shows are going to cross over. Renee Young let it slip that there are four times per year that we're going to see SmackDown and Raw pay-per-views together. I think they're going to be... Oh, reversals. Here we go. Sasha Banks drops it on. I think they're going to be WrestleMania, SummerSlam, Night of Champions, and one more. I don't know what it's going to be because they keep making certain shows more of like a flagship show than they were last year, so I can't really comment on that last show, but it's going to be WrestleMania. It's going to be SummerSlam, and it's going to be Night of Champions because it has to be Night of Champions, guys. And then there's one more. Who knows what it'll be? So unless they're cutting a promo or somebody's talking about somebody that they're going to crush at the next pay-per-view, then don't talk about Raw. The Royal Rumble. Yes, the Royal Rumble. There you go. The Royal Rumble. I can see that. Survivor Series, maybe. I don't understand how they're not going to have women's division on both. I think that they're thinking about that currently. They're figuring it out because there are women on both shows. So they can't say there's only one women's division. They can't say that there's only one women's division that actually gets to go after the women's championship. They have to do something. So who knows, man? I can't wait for them to announce it and see what it is. I think if the women's championship was a migrating championship, that would be good. It just gets defended four times a year on whatever show it is. Whatever show it is, they get to defend it four times a year versus the other show. I think that would be great. It would make it much more prestigious and much harder to close in on, and I think that would be the way to go. Why do they even have this? I'm not saying people are going to float between. I'm saying a title would float between. A title would float between. So, like, every 3 months, there'll be a pay-per-view where it's Sasha Banks versus Charlotte, and whoever wins, it goes to that show, and then they're competing for it and winning it and losing it and stuff, and then 3 months later, it'll be, you know, Bayley versus this person or Nia Jax versus this person. I think that would be a really good way to do it because it would bring prestige and would also make it so each show has their pride. Oh, get speared in half! Sasha Banks is literally in half, like a magic trick, but there's no magic about it. It's literally just you're in half. Breaks it up. Nia Jax can't be stopped. Dana Brooke, what are you doing? still means people sense someone is holding it. Well, not really, because there will just be one pay-per-view every 3 months where those two people fight. They stay on their shows, but they just bring the championship back to their show. So right now, Charlotte has it. If she wrestles somebody on SmackDown and that person on SmackDown wins it at that pay-per-view once every 3 months, then they take the championship back to SmackDown, and now it's a SmackDown title. And now Raw's got to fight amongst themselves to find out for the next 3 months who's gonna test the champion at the next pay-per-view that they all do together. Doesn't mean anybody's crossing over. It just means the championship itself will be held by one show or the other. Dana has a death wish. No, she's messing with Nia for sure. Oh, get tossed! She just gets tossed out of the ring! Suplexes. Get folded in half, Sasha. This is actually a great match. Turns her over. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Get Hemsworth. Get hemmed up. No. Get off of her. Get off of her. Nia Jax. Oh, gets tossed out of the ring. Dana Brooke is so strong in this match. Why is she so strong? She's looking like the penultimate woman in the WWE, and I don't know if she's there yet, by far. But maybe this is her breakout match. Like I said, classic historical battle starring Dana Brooke. This is the time. Charlotte, you got to get this pin right now. Stop the damage. You got to get this pin right now. Oh my God, Charlotte. You might have just lost this match. Hey, I'm going to leave so I can go to bed. Drift King, thank you very much for hanging out with us, man. It has been a pleasure. Hopefully you've enjoyed yourself here. You're missing out on the main event and a few matches before then, but you got to get up early tomorrow. So I will see you tomorrow, hopefully. Like I said, we're doing the Gritty Hangout, guys, which is where the pay-per-view is happening. You open up your pay-per-view on the WWE Network, and you open up my stream on a different device, whether it's your phone, your laptop, your tablet, whatever. You open up this stream as well as the WWE Network on some other device, and you hang out with us, because we're going to be watching it together, and we're going to be wagering on the matches, just talking about wrestling, and just having a good time together for the entire broadcast. I actually got time off from work to give you guys another Gritty Hangout, which I haven't done in a while, and I'm sorry. I'm sorry, guys, but there have been so many things. Well, I wouldn't even say sorry. I'm just saying, like, there are a lot of things that come up that are more important to me than being on Twitch, and I've been doing those things. Don't worry. I haven't been like, forget you guys. It's just things where I it's not even a choice. So now I've got the time off, and we're doing the dang thing. So be here tomorrow. Be in this stream and open up your network so we can wager on some matches, watch it together, and have our reactions together and have a good old time. It's still not enough. Why is it not enough? It's going to have the exact same feuds. There's only like 3 to 5 women and like 3 teams on each show. I see you, Kool-Aid Man, but that doesn't mean they can't expand their roster. They never said that there weren't more people coming. They never said that. All they said is they're performing a draft, and on those drafts there will be these people, not these people, but these rules. They never said that there can't be a person drafted after the fact. They never said that the next pay-per-view wouldn't introduce new people for a show. They never said any of that. Oh my goodness. Charlotte's doing it again. I told her not to do this till WrestleMania. Charlotte, you're crazy, but you're uncontrollable, I guess. Even your father couldn't say anything about this, so who am I to say I can control Charlotte? Guess I'm nobody. I will make it. Well, go ahead. I'll be looking forward to seeing all of you in there. Goes for the corner. Can Dana Brooke put this match away? Charlotte has dominated Nia Jax in ways that I never thought were possible. Maybe this game doesn't know who Nia Jax is. Oh, maybe it does know. You're a very smart man. Yeah, they never said that the draft is the end-all be-all of people coming up. Especially with the Cruiserweight Classic, it's like, okay, so you're drafting all these people, but then again, you get like 35 people or something. So the draft basically just told you the names that you'll recognize if you've been watching WWE, but doesn't tell you everybody who's going to be on Raw. Dana Brooke still kicks out and gets punched in the face by her partner. This is a miscommunication. Now she's getting punched in the face by Nia Jax. Nia is jacking your face. Come here. Come out and play. Yay. Oh, wow. Nia Jax has leveled up in the meantime. Look at this. But it's not enough. Nia Jax has leveled up between here and there. But Dana Brooke has been studying the same book and studying it harder. Ref! Yo, Kevin Baum. Kevin Baum, the ref, he is not paying attention. He said that wasn't three. I saw it. I'm closing this down. I'm closing this down. Who's winning is the question. Dana Brooke. Ooh! I don't think I've ever seen somebody pull that move off. Stares at her. Why is she just looking at her? She's got to go for the pin. Drags her. Dirty pin time. Dirty pin time. Yes, it is. The ref can't see it. That's peripheral vision. One. Two. Wow. The strength of Nia Jax. Bench presses her off of her. This is out of control. Do you think they're getting... they already announced, Kool-Aid Man, that the cruiserweight division and the cruiserweight classic is going to be part of Raw now. They already announced that. That is a straight-up fact. The Cruiserweight Classic and that division is going to be a Raw division. So some of those people you're watching every Wednesday, they're coming to Raw. They're going to be wrestling there. It's a great idea. Very great idea. Gives us some very exciting matches. It gives us brand new superstars. Something similar to NXT, but it's its own thing that's going to be on Raw every week. And it just makes Raw like... Kind of above SmackDown to me, but we'll find out. Wraps her up. Is she tapping? Dana Brooke is in there. Dana Brooke snatches her. There's no tap. This match is out of control, man. I don't know what to tell you. Wow. Are they going to wrestle like a Super Iron Woman match? An Iron Woman match. Is this going to be a half an hour match on Battleground? I don't know, but I'm letting it rock because I love this. We're going to find out right now. Just get off of her. Just get punched. We won't be in independent shows anymore. That's very wishful thinking because there are a lot of people who are doing, I would say, better things than him right now. But who knows? Maybe they see something in him other than his in-ring performance. Anything that gives me another chance to see Brian Kendrick, I'm down for. Well, it's definitely happening then. It's definitely happening. My goodness, what is this match? Nia Jax, the X Factor. It was the perfect partner for Sasha Banks to choose, because if it was Bayley, I'm not sure that partner would have the resiliency or the stamina the stamina for sure, but the strength to put damage on these characters in a way that makes sense for the win. I'm not sure. Not sure. I mean, I'm sure it would be epic either way, but Nia Jax, what a great pick. She's going out. Just unstoppable, man. Literally everyone from there. Pretty much, man. They didn't say anybody was left out. They said the Cruiserweight Classic is the launching ground for the Cruiserweight division that's going to be exclusive to Raw. So I would just say that from the way people act on there, I would say each one of them already have a pretty solid contract to wrestle on Raw. That's why people take losses and don't say anything weird about it, and don't get salty. They're just like, hey, you know, I lost. Yeah, but they still seem happy about it. They still seem respectful. So I really think that everybody in the Cruiserweight Classic is already on like a smaller deal with the WWE, but they still are guaranteed to be on Raw. I think that I think that's what's going on with the cruiserweight stuff. But there are going to be some people who are shining stars. And I'm not talking about the shining stars. Goodness gracious, the shining stars. Why the shining stars, guys? They drafted the freaking shining stars. We haven't seen them do a dang thing in so long. And before it's even Marie. It's my first time hearing this. Well, Kool-Aid Man, you're in the right place for some news. I don't know everything about wrestling, but I do pay attention to some stuff. I doubt it'll be this good tomorrow. Yeah, me too. Me too. I think it'll be over much sooner. Much sooner. They're not going to give them this type of time slot. Why would they? Why would they? They already got main event stuff to deal with. I'm not being sexist. I'm just saying, like, why would they? They already got main event stuff to get to, and they can't make the pay-per-view 4 hours again. But maybe they will. Maybe they'll surprise us. Because each one of the women in this ring deserve it. Even Dana Brooke. I've been fairly impressed with her wrestling. She's wrestled some bad matches. Not bad, but not great. Here she is. Charlotte is so fast to get in the ring. Does she have no damage on her? Why is she so fast to get in there? Get her! Yes, please, Sasha! Get this woman! Put some damage on her. Jeez, don't let her just run around here and just break up every single pin. Thank you. Here we go. This is the damage I'm talking about. Get dropped. Now get Charlotte out of the ring. Don't go for the pin yet. Please, no. Thank you. Thank you. Get her out of the ring first. Don't go for the pin. More damage. Perfect. All right, now it's time. After this, the pin. Right now. Oh, the ref moves out of the way, and now she's too close to the corner, so it's not going to happen. Oh, my goodness. Damage to the face. They're making a statement. They're like, we don't care you got Roman Reigns waiting backstage. We don't care. You got the United States Championship coming up. We don't care about any of that. We don't care you got the New Day versus the Wyatt family. We are Sasha Banks, Nia Jax, Charlotte, and Dana Brooke, and we will not be denied. They don't care who's backstage waiting for their matches. They're proving something to the world right now. What will be proved? What will be proven? Snake Eyes, that's what will be proven. Look at the strength of Charlotte. Highly doubtful, but my goodness. If that happens, I'm losing my mind. Charlotte, come on. What do you think of the substance they announced he had taken? I don't know, Arvos. I don't know what they announced. Dana Brooke gets the grab. Will it be enough, though? To the corner with you. I don't know. What was the substance? Nia Jax with the reversal. The most devastating suplex that Dana Brooke has ever felt in her life. Well, not in her life, because I'm sure she trained with Nia Jax in NXT. Because Nia Jax was like the go-to trainer in NXT, guys. I'm not sure if you know this. I'm not sure if you've seen the footage. But Nia Jax was the person who literally would just throw people around in NXT for practice to see if they knew how to take a bump right. So that's not the first time Dana has felt the pain like that. My goodness, why is she so fast to get in the ring? Does she not have a single piece of damage on her? Why is she coming in the ring like she's just, like it's round one? Or like not round one, but ding, 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 let's get it on. And then she just gets in the ring. Charlotte is so fast. Adderall? Amphetamine? Adderall. Should have had a prescription for it, didn't have one, so you got busted for it. Well, I'm not sure that that's really performance enhancing at that point. I mean, it might let him focus a little bit, but it's not like physically enhancing. So, I don't know, man. Maybe he does need it and he didn't have a prescription for it. I really don't have much of an opinion on it. As long as it wasn't something that makes you faster in the ring or something that literally overcomes... Dana Brooke. It's still not going to be enough because you're too close to the corner. And it is enough! How did they win? How do they do it? Dana Brooke. Charlotte and Dana Brooke, the strong blondes, come out of this with the victory. Nia Jax and Sasha Banks are not enough to overcome it, but I think that is a perfect outcome. It's a perfect outcome because it sets up more rivalries. It doesn't make it so it's OP. But even if they do win, it might not be perfect. It might be better if Sasha and Nia Jax win because it sets up a friendship. It also sets up the dominance. And makes it so that both of them are like kind of in the race for the women's championship. I think it would be better if Nia Jax and Sasha Banks win, but either way, great match. Holy crap, man. What a match. They wrestled for like a half an hour. No, but you. But me, but you, but mainly me. I win. I'm the best. Yeah, we know.